He lives forever, and He reigns in power and love. Let earth bow down before Him, for He is exalted, and we look to
Sandmine for Positive Life. My name is Sylvester Onyemaleji. Today we are going to be looking at mind management. Mind management. Mind management is an interesting subject because it deals with the management of our thoughts. It deals with the control, the exercising of control over our thoughts, watching over what we think, making sure that we are always thinking the right things at all times. Mind management is essential because of so many reasons, and I'm going to be looking at the reasons why mind management is essential. But first of all, I want you to understand that mind management is all about keeping your thoughts away from the wrong things, making sure your thoughts are pure, positive at all times, making sure that your thoughts are such that produce or promote peace, love, harmony. Thoughts that make you to be relaxed at all times. Joyful, because joy is essential for good health. A peaceful mind is going to produce a healthy life. But a mind that is depressed, that is heartbroken, that is burdened and saddled with so many cares, We depress the body to destroy a man's health. The Bible says it dries up the bones. That means it weakens a man's immune system and destroys his health. So how do we manage our thoughts so that we can live healthy? So mind management is essential if healthy living is on your mind. Mind management is essential if you want to keep your love life fresh and active. Mind management is essential if you want to keep your job, because sometimes there are too many stressful things that happen in our workplace. Sometimes the responsibilities given to you are too much for you to carry. Sometimes it is the overbearing boss that you have, always demanding much more than you can give, or putting you under pressure all the time. And if you don't manage your thoughts, you're going to one day just let it out. And then you're going to say things and do things that will cost you your job. So if you want to keep your job, if you want to get along with your colleagues, mind management is essential. Because you see, in getting along well with people, you need to tolerate a lot of things. You need to manage, you know, some of the weaknesses of the people, take them into account and accommodate them. And if you don't know how to take charge of your thoughts and keep the wrong things away, you discover you always have quarrels and fights and bitterness and outbursts of anger, which can cost you your job and also make your life miserable. So mind management is very important, very, very important. If you want to keep discouragement away, and you want to be always courageous, always full of hope, always full of faith, you need to manage your thoughts. If you want to please your bosses, if you want to please your colleagues, if you want to be in their good group, you need to manage your thoughts. If you want to excel in your academics, you want to excel in your choosing profession, you need to manage your thoughts, because in every area of life, in every profession, we're always having challenges, we're always having, you know, difficult situations coming up every now and then. And we do not know how to live above them and take charge of our thoughts in order to be happy and joyful, then we are going to, you know, go under, and then we become so depressed and we lose a lot of things. So mind management is important if you want to get along with your colleagues, if you want to get along with your bosses, if you want to get along with your colleagues, it's important. Mind management is important if you want to stay focused on the job. Mind management is important if you want to be able to separate your personal life from your work life, which is very important. Sometimes people do not know how to separate their personal life from their work life. There's always a carryover of some of the problems they are facing at home, in their relationship, in their finances. you know, problems with their neighbors because they are so upset about it, they are so troubled about it, so occupied in their minds. When they get to the office, the thing blow out. And sometimes they carry over the workload or the frustrations and the disappointments in the office to the home. And then they just charge at each other. And the husband comes and takes it out on the wife and the children. And the wife sometimes takes it out on the husband and the children because they have not been able to learn how to keep issues of the office in the office and go home without it. And then keep issues of the home at home when they're going out and leave it at home until they come back. So there's always this carryover, this confusion that they have within them. So if you do not know how to manage your thoughts, there will always be this mix-up, and this mix-up will cost you more. It will bring more pain, it will bring more difficulty into your life. So you need mind management to deal with these things. You need mind management, you know, to be able to handle negative attitudes from people. You need mind management to handle the negative and unkind words that people and remarks, wrong criticism and false accusations from people towards you. You can't stop people from airing out their own view. You cannot stop them from thinking whatever they want to think about you. They have the right to think anything. They can think right things and wrong things, and they can say right things and wrong things. So they are the owners of their mouth. They can say whatever they like. But you need to be able to manage your thoughts, be able to deal with these things and be able to live above them and be happy and joyful and get on with your life without allowing any of these things to hold you down. So you need mind management to handle these negative attitudes of people towards you. The negative words, the unkind words they speak, the bad remarks, the evil remarks they make about you, the wrong criticism, the judgmental statements they make about you and your work and your actions, you know. Because if you do not manage your thoughts, you're going to have issues in this area. You're really going to be struggling, and there'll be a lot of pain, a lot of bitterness, a lot of hate, and that will affect your productivity level at the office. It will affect your love life. It will affect your marriage. It will affect many things in your life. So in order not to go under and allow these things to become a burden and a weight on you, you need to learn how to manage your thoughts so you stay above them. You live above them and then be joyful. It's important. So you need mind management in many areas of your life. You need it to be able to not to fall in love with the wrong people. You need mind management. Otherwise, you're going to fall in love with another person, forgetting that you're married. And before you know what's happening, you're having an affair. If you do not know how to manage your thoughts towards people, you always see people who are more, you know, beautiful than your spouse, more handsome than your spouse, richer and better and nicer. You always meet people who please you, who manifest certain qualities or characters that you're looking for in your spouse that you have not seen. You're longing for it and praying for it, but still in the works, not yet manifested. So you can find it in other people, and if you don't manage your thoughts, you'll find yourself falling in love with the wrong people. If you don't manage your thoughts, you'll discover that you are going to get into problem here. You must always understand that affection is as a result of our thoughts. Love starts from what we think about other people. Love is actually it's an emotion that manifests as we think positively towards people. And so you need to learn how to manage your thoughts so that you can keep your relationship, stay faithful to your spouse, don't fall in love with the wrong person. And then you need mind management to live long and healthy. If you want to live long, you've got to learn to deal with negative thoughts, because there are a lot of thoughts that we are used to, negative thought patterns that we're used to. But we do not understand that these things affect our health in many ways. But as we progress in this program and as you keep tuning in every week and keeping a date with me to learn, you're beginning to understand more about the power of the thoughts, how your thoughts affect your life. You will see that things will change for you. You discover that your life is going to become better. Your health is going to greatly improve. And so if you want to manage your health, you want to live healthy and you want to live long, then you need to manage your thoughts. Then you also need a mind management to stay focused and not to be distracted by what is happening around you. You know, many times the devil wants to distract us. And the reason why men fail is broken focus. He is a master in distracting people. And if you allow him to distract you through the experiences of life, through the things that you see and hear and experience, I tell you, your life is going to be messed up and become very difficult for you. But if you know how to manage your thoughts, you are not going to allow the devil to distract you. You will stay focused. You will just face whatever you are called to do, whatever you are supposed to do. You are not going to allow what is happening in A's life or B's life to distract you. You're not going to allow what others are doing or not doing to distract you. You're not going to allow what people say they said or they did to distract you. You just stay focused. So mind management is important in this area. I also want you to know that, you know, if you want to live a life free from anxiety and free from depression, you need mind management. So to manage your thoughts is very, very important. And you know, when we come back, I want you to know that God wants you to learn a little more on this so that you can become a better person. I'm going to help you to understand it better. So you need mind management to fulfill your destiny. You need mind management to accomplish greatness in life. You need mind management to live a fulfilled life. You need mind management to live life to the fullest. You need mind management to manifest as a son of God here on earth. Otherwise, you'll still be living like a mere man when you're supposed to be living as a son of God. Stay tuned. Don't go away. I'll be right back. Welcome back. Now, I want to talk to you now on reasons why you need mind management, why you need to take managing your thoughts serious and really work on it. I want you to realize that the scripture has a lot to teach about our thoughts and the effect of our thoughts on our lives. And that is my major assignment. In this program, Sound Mind for Positive Life, I am sure that you're going to learn a lot from the scriptures about the way the mind of man works and how it affects your life. And if you will take what you're going to learn seriously, your life is not going to be the same again. The first reason why you need to manage your thoughts, one, is that it is the wellspring of life. Life springs from your thoughts. Every thought that you think within you is alive. Your thoughts are alive. They have the power to influence you. They have the power to control you. They can make you. They can remake you. They can make you who God wants you to be, and they can keep you from being who God wants you to be. It can help you to stay faithful, stay focused, and stay committed. It can also distract you. It can make you stronger. It can make you weaker. Now, the book of Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23, the NIV translation says, "Above all else, guard your heart, for it is the wellspring of life." It is the wellspring of life. You see, life springs from your thoughts. Above all else, above every other thing that you know how to do, guard your heart. So guarding your heart is guarding your mind, because the word heart is a word that encompasses the soul and the spirit of man together. And in the soul of man, you have three faculties. You have the mind, the emotions, and the will. And the mind of man is the dominant faculty in the sense that what you think determines your emotions. Your thoughts create your emotions. Your thoughts determine the choices you make. That's your will. So your will is subject to your thoughts. Your emotions is subject to your thoughts. So your thoughts, your mind, what goes on in your mind is the dominant faculty. So every man acts and behaves the way he thinks. Every man feels the way he thinks. Every man talks the way he thinks. Every man decides the way he thinks. So the scripture wants us to understand here that one of the reasons why you need to manage your thoughts is that those thoughts come alive. It is the wellspring of life. That means life springs from your thoughts. They are not just things running through the mind. They are not just ideas flowing in your head. Those thoughts are alive, they have the power to come to pass, to become a reality. And so for this reason, you need to watch your thoughts and not just give your mind to just anything. Choose what you think on and think right at all times. Think what will help you. Once you understand that your thoughts come alive, then you choose your thoughts. You don't just think anything. You don't just give your mind to just any situation or circumstance. You choose the direction in which you are going to view it or reason. You don't reason outside of the will of God. You don't reason outside of the scriptures. You let the word of God guide you in your thoughts. You view all things as it were with the eyes of God. So that at the end of the day, your thoughts will create the right experience. If you think the wrong things, you're going to have the wrong things manifest. But if you think the right things will also manifest. That's how it works. That's how man was created. So every negative thought will produce a negative experience for you. It will bear fruit. It will come alive. It will become a reality. So God says, be careful. When God says that this is important, then it's important. If God says this should be your priority, it should be your priority. Above all else, meaning you should give mind management your priority. Watching over your heart, your priority. Guarding your mind, your priority. Watching over your thoughts, your priority. Above praying, above fasting, above reading the Bible, above promising God you are going to keep His word. Above all that, it says, watch over your thoughts. For it is the wellspring of life. Why do you need to watch over it? Because life springs from it. Those thoughts will come alive. They will bear fruit. Number two, the second reason why you need mind management is that it shapes your life. It shapes our lives. It shapes my life. It shapes your life. Your thoughts shape you, make you who you are, make you become, you know, what you are today. And what if you continue in the negative way, it will make you a negative person. If you continue in a positive way, it will make you a positive person. If you continue to think of yourself as a son of God, it will shape you to become a son of God and manifest that life. If you continue to think of yourself as an ordinary man, it will make you to also be that way and manifest that kind of life. Now the same Proverbs chapter 4 verse 23, the Good News Translation says, be careful how you think. Your life is shaped by your thoughts. Be careful how you think. Your life is shaped by your thoughts. So why do we need mind management? Because it shapes our lives. So I cannot just think anything. I can't just think whatever I like to think. I have to think in line with who I want to become. I want to think in line with who that I want to become or who God wants me to be. So who do I want to become? I want to be a positive minded person. I want to be a son of God that I am. Number two, the second reason why we need to manage our thoughts, it shapes our lives. It molds us into the person that we are. The Bible says in Good News Translation of the Bible, Proverbs chapter 4 verse 23, it says, be careful how you think. Your life is shaped by your thoughts. That means that my thoughts shape me, molds me, makes me who I am, makes me behave the way I do, makes me talk the way I do, makes me live the way I live, relate the way I do. So it is important that we understand that every man's thoughts have effect on your life. Every thought that goes through your mind affects you either positively or negatively. The Bible says it shapes us. So a man who is who he is by the reason of the kind of thoughts that he thinks. A man behaves the way he does by the reason of the thoughts that he thinks. And so it is important that you and I understand this all the time. And that's why mind management is important. That's why I need to be careful what I think and keep the wrong thoughts away. Because if I know all this, what it does is that it makes me to choose what I dwell on, what I focus my mind on, how I reason over situations and circumstances, how I think when people say good or pleasant things about me, when people attack me, when people do wrong things, when I'm going through some negative experiences, I know that my thoughts is going to affect me. If I'm going to come out of it, it depends on how I use my mind. If I'm going to sink under, it depends on how I use my mind. If I'm going to be on top of the situation and be joyful in the midst of it, depends on how I use my mind. And so I need to understand this. And once you, the viewer, understands this, your life will be better lived. And so understand that mind management is essential, and is essential because your thoughts shape you. Your thoughts give you the personality that you have. Your thoughts make you either a positive person or a negative person. Your thoughts can help you stay on top of the situation or go under. Your thoughts can make the problem to overwhelm you and become too much of a burden for you to carry, and you break under it. And your thoughts can make you so strong that you are moved by the situation, that you are shaking and you come out triumphant, depending on how you use your mind. Number three reason why we need to manage our thoughts is that it determines the directions that we go in life. It determines the way you go. By direction, I mean the choices you make, the decisions you make on a daily basis. Now, the same Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23, when we read it from the New Living Translation, you get this picture very clear. It says, guard your heart above all else, for it determines the course of your life. By course, I mean the direction that you go in life, the choices that you make, the way and manner that you decide. Your thoughts determine them. Nobody makes a decision without first of all thinking. As we think, so we decide. So our choices are subject to our thoughts. Our thoughts determine what we say, how we say them, what we do, how we do them. You know, and God wants us to willingly serve Him, willingly give our time, willingly give our lives, willingly give our talents, willingly obey Him. Everything He wants it to be willingly done. It has to be a volition, a personal decision that you make, coming from the depth of your being. God never forces anybody to do anything. And for you to arrive at that level of will, you must be able to think first. Think first. That's why the Bible talks about, you know, being transformed through the renewing of our minds. Because as your minds are being transformed, as your knowledge base is changing, the way you see and the way you reason changes. And when you reason well, you are going to respond well. If you have ever read Romans chapter 12, verse 1, the Bible says, I beseech you, brethren, by the mercies of God, and ye present your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and acceptable to God. Say, this is your reasonable service. Reasonable service, a cause for reasoning. When you take into account what Jesus did, how the mercy of God was brought to you through Jesus, the pain Jesus went through, the torture He went through, the punishment, the scourging, the whipping, the crown of thorns, the heavy cross He carried, how many times He fell down, the pain that exploded within Him when He was, you know, nailed to the cross, and the whole of His weight was hanging upon the nails on His hand and on His feet. When you remember all of this and take it into account, so He said that the reasonable thing to do is to make a presentation of your life. So it calls for reasoning. Thinking, sound judgment. So nobody ever makes a decision without first of all thinking. So our thoughts are very, very important. So the Bible says it determines the course of our lives, the way we go, the choices we make, like the river course, how we flow, how we respond, how we react to situations, how we react to people, how we respond to people, the things we say in reaction to what they said, in reaction to what they did, how we live with the people after that incident has taken place. All of these are determined by your thoughts. So it's not what was done or what was said, but what you think about those things that was said, what you think about those things that was done, that determines how you react, how you live your life. So because of this, you need mind management. Manage your thoughts. Don't just give your mind to just anything. Watch what you think all the time. And then number four, the fourth reason why you need to manage your thoughts. In our subsequent editions, we're going to give full attention to this fourth reason. That is our health. Your health depends on it. If you want to really live a healthy life, you need to manage your thoughts and manage it well. It's very, very important. I'd like to share one or two scriptures here at this time. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 30. I'm reading from the NIV version. It says, a heart at peace gives life to the body, but envy rots the bones. A heart at peace, gives life to the body. That is to say that when a man is at peace, the body functions well. The health of the man is intact. The body parts, the body organs will function well. But when a man is stressed up, dried up, stressed, troubled, either by any kind of evil, especially envy, he says it dries up the bones, it drains you of life. It drains life from your bones. The stem cells begin to die. Your head begins to fail. Your immune system begins to break down. So you see, you need mind management because you need to stay peaceful. You need to stay peaceful. You need to entertain thoughts that will make you to be at peace. Thoughts that will make you to be free from bitterness, free from anger, free from hate, free from envy. Thoughts that will make you to be free from anxiety and free from worries to stay healthy. You can eat healthy, do exercises, but if your thought life is bad, your health is still going to have problems. In fact, eating healthy without mind management is a bloody waste of time. Exercises without mind management is not going to work. The greatest of them all, and where you need to focus attention, and God is saying should be your priority, is mind management. Say, above all else, guard your heart. Above all else, guard your heart. So you need to watch it. So this is very important. And the second scripture I want to read before I pray with you is Job chapter 5, verse 2. It says, resentment kills a fool.
Resentment kills a fool and envy slays a simple. Resentment is bad thoughts about people, holding grudges against another. It says it kills you, it squeezes life out of you, it breaks down the immune system, it affects you, kills you. It's not good for you. It's injurious to your health, injurious to your body, injurious to your relationship with God. It's an envy slays a simple. Who is a simple? The simple is an ignorant man. The simple is a man who lacks knowledge, who lacks understanding. That is to say, if you are knowledgeable in the truth, if you are sound in wisdom, if you know the truth, you will envy anybody. If you know the truth, you will not resent anybody. You won't hold grudges because it does not help you. Rather, it destroys your health. We're going to give time to this as we, in the next episode, I'm going to emphasize on this so that you will understand better and you will live a better life. But know this for sure, mind management is important. You need it, I need it, we all need it to live a good life. Let us pray. Father, grace to manage our thoughts, to keep evil out of our minds, to focus on the right things, to dwell on the word of God, and to see life a reason based on the word of God and who we are in Christ. May that grace rest upon my viewers today. May the Spirit of the Almighty guide you and lead you in your thought. May you not just give your mind to just anything. Grace to choose what to think on and to think on the right things. May it rest upon you forever in Jesus' name. Thank you for hearing and for answering. In Jesus' mighty name. We'll be right back. Your life to Jesus, I'd like to pray with you today. I would like you to pray this prayer and say it after me with all your heart. Lord Jesus, come into my life. I believe in you with all my heart that you died on the cross of Calvary for me and rose again after 3 days. I receive you into my heart as my Savior and my Lord. Thank you for saving me in Jesus' name. Amen. I pray for you that I pray this prayer today that the Lord indeed will come into your heart, that you will receive the life of God, that you will change from within. And that from today, the grace to live for Jesus, the grace to live for God, hunger for the word of God will enter into your heart. And you will never turn away from following Him all the days of your life. May the Lord show Himself to you. May the Lord prove Himself in your life. And I pray that every problem you have in your life presently be rolled away. Those things that bother you, those things that give you concern, those things that stress you up, that the Lord will take them away from your life. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you for viewing in today. Thank you for being part of this program. I appreciate our time together. And I want to encourage you to always tune in. Same station, same time. And always remember this. Always remember this. Be careful how you think. Your life is shaped by your thoughts. Till we meet again, stay blessed.
Forever.